welcome to yet another edition of Matt and Myra in the Morning. I'm Matt Sheridan.
I'm Myra Villas.
And it is the morning of November 1st, 2013, All Souls Day.
Taking it from the VTV studio today with our comfy new couch.
Yeah, we're switching things up. Should be a good show. We're gonna recap the week, and we're gonna talk about Halloween. A lot going on in the sports world, a lot going on TV. Everyone definitely had the Halloween spirit this weekend, wouldn't you say?
I definitely would say. Saw a lot of great costumes on campus, so looking
forward to this. Yep, but we're going to get into that later. First off, let's talk about Hoops Mania last Friday night. What'd you think?
Hoops Mania. Everyone thought it was Kendrick, and everyone was fooled. And it was Nikki. And I, for one, though, I love the dance team basketball players thing. They did a kind of like a dance competition.
Yeah, that was
fun. That really got the crowd into it. So the teams were like competing, and then you really showed off. I thought it showed off the freshmen very well.
Yeah,
they
did 1,000 miles.
Yeah, like that was so great.
You're always gonna win if you put 1,000 miles.
Great crowd pleaser.
Great song selection by them. That was a good job. Yeah, it was good. It was a good atmosphere. Everyone was fired up, and the whiteout looked cool. It was cool when they had the wave cam going back
and
forth.
The wave cam. Big fan of the wave cam.
Big fan of the wave cam. Hopefully Fox used that this year. Fox executives, if you're watching, and I'm assuming you are, get in on the wave cam for the broadcast.
If you've
It made the whole crowd look cool.
It really did.
It made a good atmosphere.
I love how like everyone loves to be on camera too. So once the camera got on them and the wave cam, people went crazy.
Yeah.
Also, if you check out Nicki Minaj on Instagram. She loved Villanova.
I know, that was pretty funny.
Absolutely loved it. She had a few videos with the women's basketball team and the men's basketball team. The men's was the funniest.
Yeah, I saw that.
Everyone was commenting what she was saying. She's like, "Do you guys have any kids?"
Yeah.
And they're like, "No." And something like,
she's like, "Don't let anybody trap you."
Don't let anyone trap you.
And they're like, "No."
Oh, it was great.
Yeah.
It was just funny because like commenters will of course like bash on like people in the videos, and they were just making fun of the basketball players.
That's funny.
Of them looking so excited and happy, but it was all in good fun.
Yeah, that was pretty funny. I saw that. I saw that on a bunch of different websites. Also, the one of her and Jay. That's the one I kept seeing, of her and Jay Wright.
I didn't see that one. I gotta look that up.
Yeah, it's just like her and Jay Wright just giving peace signs to
the
camera.
That's great. That's
and
great.
And it's pretty funny. So Nicki Minaj. That was a good show. I think everyone had a good time. She kept everybody going.
Yeah, I think everyone had a lot of fun with her.
That guy was pretty funny, man.
I don't know.
He's like, raise your hand if you're here with your best friends. Everyone's like, but then he was like, raise your hand if you've been best friends with them for more than 5 years.
Aw, that's cute.
Everyone was just like,
I wasn't paying attention to him.
In college.
I was actually like,
I met these people like 2 years ago.
Pretty much. I was on.
He has like DJ like that just say the most random things. Like the
anything
most random things.
Going.
I was at a concert this summer, and the guy was like, "Let me hear you." Or maybe this was the other night, actually. I forget. And the guy's like, "Let me hear you if you got more than $10,000 in your bank account right now."
Or did anyone say anything?
Let me hear you if you're born in the 1980s. Just like all this random stuff. Yeah, it's just.
I feel like the crowd would have been like really dead, like cricket.
I think it's like
no
type
one's
of
making
thing.
More of that money if you're straight
I think
out
it's
of college.
Like the type of thing where everyone yells no matter what.
Yeah.
Because at one point he said, "Raise your hand if you're 21 years old and you can drink legally," and 95% of the arena went nuts. And you know, I highly doubt that was the case for 95% of the pavilion last Friday night.
Everyone wishes they were 21 or older.
Yeah. What else happened last weekend?
We had a lot of things with homecoming, and Ignite the Night was a big highlight of the weekend, where we had the DJ out also at the Oreo, and a lot of students came out, and it was just a big party out there, a lot of fun on the Oreo, people going crazy, raising money for Villanova.
Yeah, so, I saw that commercial. You guys should look it up if you haven't seen
Father
it.
Father Peter looks great in it. Father
like,
Peter, if you're watching.
2 minute. Don't take my line. That 2 minute commercial thing is like pretty awesome.
It is pretty awesome.
About igniting change or whatever.
I wanted to be in it. I was trying to look for myself, but apparently every little shot, even though it looks like it was just like candid, they're staged.
Oh, yeah, I know. I remember I was watching them, like, film when Father Peter's just talking to students.
Because that doesn't really happen. He doesn't honestly just stand on the Oreo steps and preach. But
yeah, that would be pretty cool if he did. That would
be pretty hilarious, actually.
Father Peter, if you're watching right now, you know, maybe he should do that because it's a good idea.
But I guess it was a great campaign because we had the Davis family donate $50 million to our school.
That's pretty good.
The campaign is for like $600 million.
But you know, before it started, before this video came out, I guess they were kind of doing it like a little more quiet. They had already raised, I think, $285 million.
Good for you, Villanova.
Yeah.
Does this mean my tuition is going to be cheaper? No.
Yeah, we'll see.
But yeah, the $50 million, that's a great donation, but also to the VSB school. So.
Yeah, it's still cool. Davis,
I never met Davis Villanova before, but they also did the
Davis Center.
Yeah.
Naturally.
I think they're trying to get the whole university named after
them. They rock. Good for them. All right. Big week in sports. The Red Sox, much to my dismay, the Boston Red Sox won the World Series. I'm a Yankees fan, and I was in a room with like five Red Sox fans
during
the
game
the other night. So, yeah, that was kind of rough. But, I mean,
guess who's winning next year?
They're a good team. Who's winning next year?
The Cubs. That's the greatest joke of the century.
Doubt it. I highly doubt the Cubs are going to win. I mean, I think the Yankees are probably going to win. You know, that's just me, but I'm pretty sure they're going to win the World Series next year, and I can't wait. It's going to be sick.
Yeah.
But, I mean, you know, credit goes out to the Red Sox. They did a good job this year.
I have a lot of friends who are going back home to Boston this weekend.
For the
parade? They can go to the parade, so that'll be a lot of good fun.
Yeah, see, my friends from Boston, I guess they're just bums because
they're not going to the parade?
They're not going to the parade.
If you're there in Boston, like...
Yeah, they probably should, actually. Have you ever been to a victory parade before?
I was supposed to
go. They had Blackhawks a couple times.
I was supposed to go to the Blackhawks parade this past summer, but I was working for an internship, and I had to be up like early morning at like 3 or something at a site and had to be there all day.
What kind of internship was that?
It was for a radio station. So
that's pretty cool.
I also helped at the morning show for the radio station, and it was on location for like a big festival. So that morning we had to go there early. This one was a news station, but I worked for an agency that had 4 stations. So, but particularly that day it was for the news station.
That's pretty cool.
It was fun.
That sounds cool.
But they did cause me to miss a Blackhawks parade. Pretty bitter, but I'm pretty sure we'll be in like a good spot this year. So if we.
I might still have another chance this year
to go to the parade.
I went to the Giants Super Bowl parades both the last 2 times I did it. Skipped school to go. Weird. It was the best.
One day.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Giants are 2-6 now, so Super Bowl, it's going to be, you know, I think they're going to make it and win, personally.
I have high expectations,
but realistic expectations, because the rest of the NFC East is not good, and the Giants are coming on. Did you see Patrick Kane in the first time Blackhawks won a few years ago when he was like wasted at the parade?
No, I did not see that.
Look it up on YouTube. It's hilarious. Patrick Kane, that guy does what he wants at the end of the day. So good to him. Good for him. What else happened this week? NBA started. Big D Rose fan over here. You had a big shot last night.
Crazy thing I heard was a family friend at home is a photographer. Got to do a photo shoot with Derrick Rose. Like,
that's pretty cool.
Met him. Just got to shoot him. Like,
yeah,
what is your life? So, but yeah, last night against the Knicks, got that final like game winning point against the Knicks and beat them by 1.
Yeah.
There was like 5 seconds left. It was beautiful.
Yeah, it was a good game. I think everyone's excited to have Derrick Rose back in the NBA.
President Obama tweeted, "Welcome back, D Rose."
Really?
So it's that big. Just
I think
just,
it's so
you know,
funny.
Leader
that...
Leader of the free world just loves Derrick Rose, so you should too.
Yeah, that is pretty cool. I think it's funny that Barack Obama like has a Twitter. My sister responds to him, all caps, says, "Follow me back, please."
Oh my god, you guys follow people back.
I know, which is just
I'm
like
pretty
hilarious.
Sure he follows
like,
me.
Can you imagine having the leader of the free world just following you on Twitter?
Yeah. That's probably some like really low staff intern that doesn't.
Yeah. No, it's definitely the case.
Yeah.
But what else? In the NBA?
I mean, like, hold on.
Wait,
just
right,
to say
ahead,
no, like the Pope's like Twitter is run by a Villanova student intern, so
yeah, the Pope's
technically
Twitter's
like leader of like the religious community, basically. That big powerful man is also led by a little intern.
The Pope's Twitter is pretty good too. If you look at what people respond to the Pope on Twitter when he tweets, I can't repeat some of it.
Yeah.
But like I could just tell you it's really funny.
I think we should do a segment one day on funny tweets back to.
Yeah, that's a good idea actually.
They get pretty ridiculous.
Elsewhere in the NBA, last night the 76ers, maybe that was two nights ago. Michael Carter-Williams, in his first return to the Wells Fargo Center since Nova Nation got in his head when Villanova played Syracuse, I started a Lord and Taylor's chant in the crowd.
That was you?
Yeah, it was me that started that. I was telling everyone around me. I was like, say Lord and Taylor's, because you robbed those bathrobes in college. And there was, like, that guy, and everyone, it just, like, caught on. And everyone around was like, and there was one guy, like, standing up wearing a bathrobe. That was a great day for the nation. But yeah, Michael Carter-Williams went off, almost had a quadruple double, and they beat the Heat, and the Sixers are supposed to be the NBA's
beat
worst
the
team.
Yes.
So that was pretty good. That was good. Yeah, so in the world of TV, The Walking Dead is on.
The Walking Dead, one of my favorites, because the thing with zombies nowadays, I don't know, it's a big fad, but this show definitely got started. The fourth season of Walking Dead is on right now. It's a few episodes in, I think about three episodes in. And get back to it if you haven't, because it's a great show.
I've never watched it.
I don't want to give any spoilers, but there's no more governor this season.
Spoiler
but
alert.
Back in, well, you saw the end of the third season, governor's dead. fourth season starts, they're back in the jail, and it's just, and now it's not outsiders ruining the whole community, it's from like the inside out, so there's something going on that's killing everyone, so.
Wow, yeah. That is intense.
Get into it. It would help you all learn about how to live if there's a zombie apocalypse, so.
I watched World War Z, so I learned that all zombies don't go near you if you're sick.
Really?
That's the rule. That's according to World War Z, and I heard that's based on true story, I'm assuming, so.
Okay, yeah, it was.
No, I'm kidding.
It was based on Brad Pitt's, like, life. Yeah.
World War Z was pretty good. I mean, I don't know. I've never really got into Walking Dead, but so be it. American Horror Story, what about that?
American Horror Story this season, every season they have the same cast, but they have them put into different, like, setting and they play different characters.
Yes.
So this season they're a coven. It's called American Horror Story Coven. So they're a bunch of witches in New Orleans, and it's about like the witches against like the voodoo kind of witches down there too. So it's weird because it's like a witches school.
Yeah, yeah. I've never watched it, but I kind of heard people talking about it. I heard it's really good. But
it's kind of a little bit is. Like, it focuses on, like, girls in the school, so that seems kind of Mean Girls-y.
Oh, yeah? You don't like this season as much as the earlier seasons?
That's
what I've heard.
I like the historical, like, side they have to it. They like, go into the early, like, New Orleans, like, kind of Civil War era uh-huh. when the voodoo down there, how that happened.
Okay.
And then, like, apparently the witches there are the witches from Salem, so it's kind of cool.
All right.
Definitely pretty cool.
I could jive with that. I might get into American Horror Story. I mean, probably not, because...
It's in the season of Halloween, so...
stuff, but...
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's definitely
pretty cool.
It's the freakiest show on cable, so... All
right, yeah. So, I mean, we'll see. We'll see. Sounds good, though. Thanks for the good television update. Myra, in touch with what's going on TV.
Of course, because right now we're on a newsroom hiatus, so I don't know what to do.
Yeah, me either.
Come back, newsroom. Just come back.
Yeah, it might not. We'll see. Speaking of newsroom, Halloween.
Hold on. I was totally on a different wavelength. I thought you were going to go where I was going.
Poor segue.
I thought you were going to go where I was going. Did you know there was going to be a Dumb and Dumber 2?
Yeah. See, the thing is, wasn't there already a Dumb and Dumber 2?
Probably a poorly done one.
Yeah, I think, I don't know. I don't know too much about Dumb and Dumber.
Okay, I just know that, what's his name? Jeff Daniels. Jeff Daniels and Jim Carrey.
Will McAvoy.
Yeah, Will McAvoy of The Newsroom, aka Jeff Daniels. He like tweeted a photo of him in his like Dumb and Dumber costume.
Oh yeah, yeah. I heard about that.
Showing that there's gonna be a Dumb and Dumber 2.
Yeah, that'll be cool. So if you're a Dumb and Dumber fan, this should be a good, exciting time for you. And now back to my...
Now we can segue into
speaking of people being in costumes.
There was some great Dumb and Dumber costumes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So you were taking some pictures of people around campus?
Yeah, I asked permission sometimes.
I would hope so. Because, I mean, you know, if you weren't, so be it.
Friends sent me pictures,
Sent pics. That's good.
Some were, some I can't show you, but some are great.
What were some of your favorites?
Okay, so we had... my friend Lauren just put on a onesie, like a cheetah cat onesie. So it's perfect for Halloween trick-or-treating because it's cold out. So it's nice and furry, full body onesie with a tail. So it was great.
No, I actually saw
Wild
her.
Cat.
I saw her in the pit last night.
Yes, she was there.
Wearing that like cheetah onesie.
Yeah.
And I think I said, you know, I was like, you know what? That takes a little bit of, respect to her for just walking around in a onesie all day. Plus, I'm sure it was comfortable.
Exactly.
So,
if I could, I'd wear a onesie all day long. So comfortable.
Yeah.
I don't have one. I need one, though.
Yeah.
Maybe one day we could buy onesies and wear them on this morning show. It's a morning show. I had another friend who dressed as a 1920s flapper, which is kind of a classic thing, especially with the whole Gatsby thing going on.
Yeah, I think the whole Gatsby 1920s like girls was definitely one of the more popular Halloween costumes out there. I feel like I saw a lot
one.
Of those on like social media and whatnot.
Yeah, my friend got it from Pinterest, but it's a very simple costume. They just had to get a nice dress.
Yeah.
And then pearls and like a headband. So another friend was a soccer player. I think guys is one of their go-tos if they have a soccer jersey.
Yeah, just like any type of jersey.
Yeah.
I feel like if you don't have anything else, just wear a jersey and that'll do most times sure.
Yeah, one of the cool things on campus that I saw yesterday with Halloween was the Mario Kart characters.
Oh, that's what they were. I saw a couple guys walking around like Mario and Luigi and stuff.
They actually went to do like a real live Mario Kart kind of thing, and they went in the quad with their scooters and were scootering around in circles around everyone. We had some Pikachu, Princess P, Mario, Luigi, obviously.
Yeah, it was pretty fun.
So those were one of the most popular on campus. I ran into a professor. I think he was a professor, or he's a grad student or something. He was just like carrying a briefcase, looked all professional and whatnot, and then his shirt though was very, it was blood stained and looked like he just got an accident or something.
That's you usually rely on teachers to do something a little weird on Halloween.
That was a good one.
What?
I did full gorilla suit.
John's did a full gorilla suit. There you go. That's just...
That's dedication.
That's dedication.
And he taught in that?
For 10 minutes, he did nothing but gorilla noises.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, I don't know if you heard that, but John just said for 10 minutes, his teacher did nothing but gorilla noises in class. That's pretty cool.
That's awesome.
Do you want to hear a pretty funny Halloween story, actually?
Yeah.
All right, so junior year of high school, my friends and I, we see this video on YouTube, and it is one guy... is dressed up as Pac-Man, and the rest of them are dressed up as
like the ghosts.
As the ghosts, and like a banana and all that stuff, right? And what you did basically is you just run around and Pac-Man chases them.
That's awesome.
Yes. So my friends and I, we did that, and we all meet up at my buddy's house.
Who are you? One of the ghosts? Or
yeah, I was one of the ghosts.
Yeah.
Or the banana. I forget what. And I think I was both. And so we meet up at my friend's house, and we all go to school together, and we gather in the parking lot, and all of a sudden we're like, all right, let's go. And we just start running, and we're just, like, sprinting down, and we sprint into the school, and we're going, like, through the hallway, just running. Everyone's running, right? And we get to one point, and one of the teachers just freaks out, like...
Ooh, I freaked out. It's a little cord thing. Good. There we go.
Yeah, so one of the teachers freaks out, and like, so then, like, a couple teachers freak out, and so then we all kind of
just because you guys are running.
Yeah, I don't know why, because some like half the teachers thought it was hysterical and loved it.
Yeah.
All the kids loved it, and we had this new principal that year who everybody hated, and there was like a couple like cranky old teachers basically. And they, like, freaked out, and really one in particular. So we all kind of scattered, And, like, four of my friends that were involved ended up getting cornered basically in the cafeteria by the new principal that everyone hated.
Oh, my gosh.
One of my friends thought that everyone was caught instead of, like, just the few of them. So he walked out and gave himself up. The rest of us got off free. They ended up getting, like, suspended from school for, like, a day or two.
Just for running around.
Yeah, it was bad. This guy was a lunatic, this principal. He, you know, said things like they could have killed someone. Like, literally, that's what I think he said, they could have killed someone. Like, someone could have died. And, you know, that was kind of absurd. But that's overall, that was a pretty good Halloween experience. It was fun.
That sounds like a fun one.
Yeah, it was good. Yeah. It was good.
Like, one of the most popular ones I've definitely seen this year, like, tons of people wanted to be this. They wanted to be a minion from Despicable Me.
Minions are hysterical. Yeah. I've never seen Despicable Me 2.
I haven't seen it either, yeah.
Yeah, but, really funny, though. Yeah, minions, they're pretty hilarious.
Got those overalls.
Yeah.
And the cool goggles and yellow skin. They're cute.
Yeah, that's pretty good. So, yeah, Halloween was definitely a good time. A lot of people had some good costumes. This coming weekend, what do we got?
We got SPO.
Which is Special Olympics.
Special Olympics.
I don't know if we have ever made that clear.
A lot of sports going on, like soccer, bocce ball,
some
long
hoops.
Distance.
Running.
One of the coolest ones, though, is like...
Fun atmosphere on campus. Powerlifting.
Powerlifting, yes. Yeah. Powerlifting. Go to powerlifting because J.J. Brown, I don't know if you know him, but he's going to be the announcer and he's going to be really funny.
That'll be good. That'll definitely be fun.
We also have roller skating. It's not on campus. They go, I guess they go...
Oh, yeah. Pat was talking about that last week.
It's like speed skating or something.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
I want to see that. I've never thought that was like... Olympic.
Yeah, thing, I know. So. Yeah, it's definitely fun every year when they come out. It kind of takes over the campus for a couple days. Should be a good time.
And on Sunday morning, I think a big thing that people like to watch out for are the relay races. So check those out.
Yeah, that'll be good. So that's it for this week. It's been a good show. Next week, we've got one of the members of Nova NASA, which is like the Indian dance team here at Villanova. They're pretty good.
They compete.
I've seen them a couple times.
Yeah, they've got great performances coming up soon, so you don't want to miss that.
Yes, and our special guest, Neil Patil, I'm banking on it being him. Hopefully it is. He can rap. So he might drop a couple freestyle bars here on Matt and Myra in the morning.
Yes.
I'm kind of laying the gauntlet down now. Hopefully that this kind of forces him to show up and do it. You know, maybe we didn't have a guest.
I don't think he's much of a morning person.
We didn't have a guest this morning.
That's the trouble.
Because it was 7:30 in the morning,
the day after Halloween.
So we might, we might have to drag
Neil.
We might have to drag Neil and Jin. And we might get Jin,
who's
he's a Heat fan. So we can get into it with that.
He's one of those people who every time I post a status about the Bulls, he comments on it and like bashes on the Bulls.
Yeah.
Every time.
Yeah, so those guys,
we're going to get into the discussion next week.
That'll be good. We'll have a roundtable discussion. And until next time.
Yep. Thanks for watching Matt and Myra in the Morning. We'll see you next week.
See you next week.
They played the Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They played the Mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They played the Mash.
They played the Monster Mash. Out from his coffin, Rex's voice did ring. Seemed he was troubled by just one thing. Opened the lid and shook his fist and said, whatever happened to my Transylvania twist?
It's now the Mash.
It's now the Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
And it's a graveyard smash.
It's now the Mash.
It's caught on and flashed.
It's now the Mash.
It's now the Monster